Hey Don, we're going out today. One of my pickers has a bunch of stuff he had before the pandemic that's been sitting there. I have a official mask. I've got rubber gloves here. I've got the whole works. Hey Don, we're going out today. One of my pickers has a bunch of stuff he had before the pandemic that's been sitting there. I have a official mask. I've got rubber gloves here. I've got the whole works. We're gonna take a drive. He's about, say, 30 or 40 minutes away. Now, I don't really need anything today, but this is one of the things you have to realize if you do get pickers, that if you don't come out and look at their stuff, next time they get something good you may want, they may not call you because you don't show up when they call them. So you are almost required to some extent to go out and see your pickers when something shows up on their site. Again, he's had this stuff for a while. I would have looked at it prior to the pandemic either way. So at this point, I'm being safe. You know, everything is, you know, situated. So off we're going to go right now. So here we are. This is his building that he has. It's just got a bunch of, I guess you'd say, junk laying all over the place. But this is just where he dumps his stuff at. Bunch of records. 78s is part of the reason I wanted to come out here. I'm going to look at, obviously, everything he's got. I'll come back and look at these in just a few moments. But working at a theater, I always love finding the movie-related stuff. You can see The Shining. Some pretty interesting stuff, including this North Dallas 40 poster. It's worth like 20 or 30, so I'll probably nab that one up as well. The records, though, I'm pretty excited about. There's several hundred of them here. He picked these as well, only the best condition ones, so it usually saves me a lot of time and aggravation. He's got other buyers too, so what I don't buy, there's country buyers he has that don't necessarily buy them all to resell, but buy them to just have them. There was probably around 500 or 600 total 78s that I looked through. And then I looked through a bunch of 45s, which you'll see in just a few moments here. Now, all these, including like this RCA, they look like they've been sleeved since they were new, probably. Some of these look like they haven't been played at all, which even some not so great music, if it's in like mint condition, which would be E minus to E. In the VJM scale, I'll still take a shot on some of them because they still will sell. Now, there's a lot of good country boppers, is what they call them in this lot here. And those are the ones I'm really excited about here because I've already seen some that I know that are worth 50 bucks or so. So I really can't go wrong. Now, I'm not going to be looking up most of these here just because I don't want to worry about taking gloves off and messing with my phone. So I bought a few extra. And then I dug through these here. Now, I worked at a theater, as I said, so I know that this is only part of a press book. The photos aren't here, the folder's not here. It's only worth a few bucks, and he wanted five on this just because of the movie Star Trek, and it just wasn't worth it. The Shining or Ad Slicks, that's not complete. They're not worth it as well either, so I passed on most of that. Now, 45s, there was around 3,000. This is two boxes high. He had a few he pulled out as well, but there was literally about 3,000 45s I went through to get the ones that I'll probably show off in another video. But excellent score here. Okay, I just got back. This is what I got. Not a ton of stuff, it doesn't look like. I've already taken stuff out of bags and boxes because I wanted to get my gloves off. Now, this stuff's been setting for a while. This is certed as well. I got it for my son, so I spent some extra money on this one. Obviously, you should know who this is. This is AC/DC. I believe Angus Young and Malcolm Young, two of the founding members. My son's a huge fan, so anyway, that's for him. But the rest of this, there's some paper. I've got some 78 records down here as well, as you can see. Here's a whole box. And now I know you can't see it very well, but there's a whole box of 16mm World War II and up era films, some 45s, military films, some cars, and some posters. I got around 100 bucks into everything, and we're gonna take it inside, and I'm gonna show you what I got. There's some nice stuff here. So I'm inside now. I've got everything in here with me. Probably my favorite piece that I got is this. I paid $6 for this, and I paid $6 for the other tube, which I'll show you in just a minute. This is a 1958 calendar, and as you see, it has December 1957, so you could give this as a gift or use it in December. Then it has the whole next year all the way through 58. So this is complete plus, in excellent condition. Just a fine example. Now, I might flatten this out just a little bit here where this has got the roll to it. I don't know yet for sure, but this will sell easily, and I do mean easily, for 60 to say 75 bucks as a bin, pretty much right off the bat would be my guess, due to the condition. This thing is excellent. The white is white in this, and I just don't see them very much like that either. Now, I'm not going to show you the address, but this is a mailing tube for a send-away item, and what was in there was these rolled papers. Now, I expected this to be 3 foot long photos, usually World War II photos I see like that in those mailing tubes. But this is actually a little bit better. Now, hopefully you can see that there. Now I'm going to have to start rolling it back up there. But this is from, what's the date on here? 1952. This is Peter Rabbit and his friends. This is a Beatrix Potter. And these are borders that would go around a kid's room. And there's three of them here. So there's three individual ones of these in here. These sell for like 65 to say 100 bucks with the mailer. So I was very happy. Again, I paid 12 bucks for the poster and this together. So I have almost nothing into this at all, in all honesty. This will pay for almost everything I got today, just these two items. And as I said, they'll sell quick. This should sell very, very quick. There's only one other example on there, and there's some on some of the other platforms, and I'm sure you'll probably be able to track some of these down that sold even higher than that, again, with the mailer in here. It only costs 7 cents to send this out, which is just incredible. What's the date? Yeah, 52, as we said on this one. So very, very nice one here. Now, I got a book here too. This sort of thing I always grab up. War Diary, USS Alabama. This is from 1944, this book, from what it looks like. I can't find an official date in it. These sell from around 40 to say almost 100 bucks a piece on these. I'm going to put it on the high end, and I'm just going to let it sit. It has a lot of nice, interesting photos and imagery. It's in very fine condition as well. It's got all the members of the staff, the commanding officers, and then it also has everybody else in here. This is like a yearbook of sorts for the crew members. Now, along World War II items, I got these two, and I have two of them here. If I can unravel them. Now, this is a lineman's telephone. It looks pretty much like it's minus the cord, and many people will say, hey, that's not all there. Who wants a handset? This is not just a handset. This is a lineman's piece. They could plug it into a wire. But if you look closely here, try to get a picture of it, you can see signal core handset. This is from 45 one. So this is a World War II lineman's phone from the U.S. Signal Corps, which is part of the U.S. Army, basically. They would handle telecommunications, I guess you would say, back in the day. Now, I paid $6 a piece for these as well, which I'm very happy to spend on these. These at the bottom end go for around 30 bucks at the bottom end, and I have two of them. So always happy to get more than just one. This one's 1944, and this one, as you saw, was 1945. War issues, they're very heavy. I'll probably get about 45 bucks a piece for these, in all honesty. I'll just put them up, leave them, and be done with it. These can be sold on several different platforms as well. Now, I did get a couple of cars. Now, this is a 95 DC Comics Hallmark ornament. Now, I paid 50 cents for this. I probably wouldn't have spent more than that. These only go for about 6-8 bucks out of season. Around Christmas time, I should get, say, 12 to 15. I have a couple other Hallmarks that are sitting here, and I'll just list them at the same time. It's in excellent condition. Nothing wrong with it. Very finely detailed on the top, as you can see. I love this sort of thing. It brings back fond memories of watching the show. Now, this one was 50 cents as well. I'm not sure what the brand is on this one, but it has like a guide post that's made out of metal. So it almost makes me think that this goes to a car carrier. Had it not had that little piece on there, I don't know if I would have gotten it. But these car carrier ones, which again, I'm almost sure that's what this is, those kind of cars are usually lost because they're not well taken care of. The big vehicle itself is usually found fairly often. It's these type of cars that are many times harder to get than the actual carrier itself. Now, I say car carrier as well because if you look at the bottom, it does not have metal wheels. It's just meant to sit there. And this makes me think, too, the way this is mounted with this piece here, this would hold whatever it is into place when it sits up on something. So I'm almost sure this goes to a car carrier. I've seen other ones with mounting pins similar to this. Now, the car carrier is going to be metal on these. So if that is the case, in which I'm almost sure it is, you need something metal to mount down to it. And again, that's why this is here. This goes past the wheels too, if you've noticed. So it can't be rolled by the front end. So I'm almost sure that's what this is. And as something like that, marking it correctly, I'll probably look at $15 or so for this. Now, not knowing or not listing it that it's a car carrier version, you probably won't sell it for much at all. But I am almost sure of that. Nylint would be my guess on which one this goes to. Now, I did get some records, as I said, and I did discard 12 of them. I just snagged them for a dollar. I don't mind spending that kind of money when I know I'm getting good money back in return for this. Had there not been something in the lot here, I probably wouldn't have taken the chance on those. But on one of the ones I did take a chance, it's worth well over what I got out of them. So let me just show you some of the 78s here. Now, this one's Frank Yankovic. Now, if you look this one up on PopPsych, it sells from $200 to $500. This one almost never shows up. Some of Frank Yankovic discs can go for like $1,000. I got three by him. This is one you should always nab up, too. There are other ones on the same Columbia label. I think Joe Was a Boxer is another one that you'll find by him. Here's just another example, as you can see. Three Yanks Polka. This one's fairly scarce. Now, on these three records, I should get close to 500 easy for the three of these, even if the price is down on the most expensive one. So that's $3. I can say $12 that I discarded. So I got $15 into at least $300. Again, look these up if you've got a doubt on what they would go for. Now, I got some other interesting records here. This one is a Hebrew, probably some obvious Jewish comedian, and these sort of things do go very well. Just being Hebrew in general does sell some of these earlier records, since there's not a lot of them floating around. So, now I did get some country, what's called boppers. Now this is Ann Jones. Most of these are fairly scarce. King label, it's a 78 10-inch speed record, excellent condition. Many of these I'm going to put up for $57.50, and as a bopper, something like this, a country bopper, which is almost a rockabilly, but not, it's not quite a bluegrass. It's like a early dawning of rockabilly in my book. But that's a really good one here. Bob Eaton here is another bopper. You can tell by the song title sometimes. Somebody's Stealing My Baby's Sugar. Now, this is a bopper all the way. $57.50 or higher on this one was what I'll put. Most of these will sell for $35 to $40 without a problem, including many that may sell at the initial list price, too. Now, this is Ma Rainey, Catfish Baby. This is another bopper. Again, boppers are what you want. You can see it's in excellent condition. I do clean these at the end of the day after they sell. As long as I can take a clean shot, a picture of it, I won't clean them until they sell. As long as I've looked at them very closely and know that there isn't any issues that I'll have to list on them too. Now, this is a really junk label. This is like a five and dime store label, Gateway Top Tunes. They did compilations on lesser known stars. But when the song on it is a true classic rockabilly rocker like Jailhouse Rock and Elvis song, they go for some good money. There's no examples of this one selling, but I've sold dozens and dozens of Gateway. I do believe it's from my local area in Ohio here because I turn up these all the time. This one's going to be worth at least $50 from what I would say. Dave Remington's Orchestra is a known group, but again, they usually play backup on lesser known cheapos like this. And on top of one side, the other side is another Elvis song. So that's why I say this one's $50. For a dollar, I'm completely happy with it. Just looking at the records I got today, there's over $1,000. You can follow along. You can look these up as well if you wish to do that. But you will see I'm pretty accurate on the prices on these as well. Here's another on the King label. Again, this is circa 1940s to early 50s. Excellent one here. Louis Innes, this is fairly nice example of it. But what's also interesting, it has the jukebox slip in it as well. Some of these little pieces of paper here, these jukebox slips from Top Known, like an Elvis or something, an original one like this, they can sell for $15-$20 or even higher on their own in some cases. So excellent one here as a bopper again, $57.50. I should sell it $35 to $40 without any problem whatsoever. Now here's Jim Boyd. You can see it's an interesting topic title on this one, I hope. Truck Driver Boogie. So this is another one of those bopper, almost rockabilly. This one I'll probably put $75 on or higher. I can't find another sold example in a decade or better. So some of these are very scarce. They didn't sell a lot of them. This is like a sideline genre. It's not country. It's not really rock. There was a small limited market for some of those back then. So they didn't make a lot of them. And some of those were only released regionally from the information that I can find too. Now here is Rod Morris, Three Empty Bottles. Another one of those country boppers. It's almost like an outlaw country from the day to some extent, I would say. Excellent condition. It's on Capitol. 50s on this one as well. Now here's the Oklahoma Wranglers. Let's get this in focus here. And this is Candy in a Room with a Baby. Another excellent bopper here. This one should do very well. $45-$50, I would gather. The condition on these is just superb. It looks like they've never been touched. They're in sleeves that are in like really nice condition as well. Whether they're the right sleeve or not, they've been well taken care of without a doubt. Many of these look like they probably never have been played. So that's why I say I'm going to get the top end on all of these. Now I might get 75 to 100 on these, all the ones in E minus to E condition, which is top notch condition. And that's VJM grading on those. Now here's Fair and Young Going Steady. This is a known bopper. This, I would say, is considered a rockabilly to some extent as well. Again, looks like it's never been played. You can just see the fine condition on these. E minus to E. Again, $50 or better. Fair and Young isn't a super, super hot seller, but stuff like that will do very, very well. Now this is Jimmy Lee on this one here. I Got a Broken Heart to Heal. And on the other side, Lips That Kiss So Softly. Again, another bopper here. So this one's probably around the $30-$35 market should sell for. Now here's an Earl Songer. This is a Detroit Fortune label. Now some on this label I've sold for $400 and $500. So every time I see this label with something that looks country rockabilly or doo-wop or R&B, I'm pretty much over it all the time. This one was a no-brainer. This one's probably worth close to $90. Sale price on this one here, not my list price, but what it should sell for. So again, there's a good 1,000+ just in the records on this. I spent less than $100. Let's just show you just a couple items of paper as well. If I get a lot of feedback from this, I may do another video and show you some other items from this haul. Now here's an interesting piece of paper. This is a full-fledged engraved image, and this is a program, and it's for the graduating class of, let's see here, Western College in Iowa. It's from 1886. It's got a whole instructional program of what's going on. I've got a lot of interesting pieces like that as well. Concert tickets and programs and promotional things from universities, all from the 1800s. Another graduation piece here. Nice, interesting. It's Mozart. I got some of these as well, which I've shown you many times before. This is V-mail. This one here is probably with Santa Claus on it being a picture, worth $45 to $70 on this one here. Again, I got less than 100 in everything. Here's an interesting piece here. It's a military piece, and it came with a bunch of whack material. Women's auxiliary, very interesting. Here's a graduation from their class. Here's an individual 8x10 of one of the whacks as well, and it's on a cloth-lined paper. So now I also got this here, And these are 16mm films. There's quite a few things in here, including some newsreels, but some of these are like from some interesting areas. Let's see, which one is this one? Lots of locations, but some of these say like Guam and Snafu, which are military related ones. So let's see what this one is here. Sodor, which I'm not really sure. There's University of Toledo from the 1940s. Portsmouth, this one's pretty interesting. This one says Guam. I've looked at this one as well. It's from the 40s, so, and it does look like it has some military content. Now, again, these are 16 millimeter, so I will spend far more on 16 millimeter with this sort of content. Again, you can see it's a pretty good size box. These cans, these metal cans that the reels are in themselves, I can probably get 10 or 15 bucks a piece with the reel in each one. So even if I didn't do anything with the film itself, I've got well over the 25 bucks I spent on this whole box just in the cans. If I sold the cans, I'd triple my money almost just from the cans with the reels in them. So again, think about that. If the film is damaged or you're not sure on it, if it has cans, you can still make some money off of it. That's what I have, I guess, for you today. Again, I'll probably show some in a Patreon video. If you want to see some other items of the paper, close-ups and things like that here, leave a bunch of comments down below, and I'll probably do that if I get a bunch of feedback on it also. But anyway, that's what I have. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit that like button down below. You can also hit the bell icon to be notified if I post new content or go live. Subscribe and tell all your friends. Let's not think of bull. We'll give you more than beer.